There's a long list of firsts that apply to Willa Brown Chappell. Here are just two of them. She was the first African-American officer in the U.S. Civil Air Patrol, and she co-founded the first private flight training academy owned and operated by African-Americans. This remarkable Kentuckian was a pioneer in American aviation. In her quest to be the best, you could argue this Western Kentucky native spent her life proving that nothing is beyond our reach, no matter how high we have to go to achieve it.
Well, I think anytime you're a first at anything, that's a challenge in itself. And being the first African-American woman in the United States to get a pilot's license, and she also was a licensed and certified mechanic, that set her apart from a lot of other women. And typically, women weren't allowed to pursue those kinds of technical careers.
Her name was Willa Brown, born in Glasgow, Kentucky in 1906.
A biracial family, a Native American mother, an African American father who was a preacher. And after her early years, three, 4 years, they migrated up to Terre Haute, Indiana, where she finished the rest of her primary schooling and education.
Education was important to the young Willa.
She went to college at the Indiana Teachers College, and she got a bachelor's degree in business, and then that was 27. In 1937, Willa got an MBA from Northwestern University, and then she became a teacher at Gary, Indiana. She taught school, and then she moved to Chicago, where she became a social worker.
But a chance encounter changed the course of Willa's life in the form of pilot Cornelius Coffey.
She fell in love with this idea of aviation. And she helped Cornelius with his flying school, and she trained under Cornelius, and they later married.
He got married, and they started an aviation school on the south side of Chicago.
It was just one of Willa's first, the first private flight training academy in the U.S., owned and operated by an African-American. In 1938, she became the first African-American woman to earn a private pilot's license in the U.S. The young aviator was a pioneer for both women's and civil rights.
And women back in the 30s or 40s, even early 50s, they were considered as domesticates, you know, people that just house cleaning and babysitting and all of those life taking care of situations, you know. They weren't expected to be professionals. You know, I would say that Willa Brown was probably one of the first women suffragists that just stepped out on faith to be her own self.
When they started the Coffey School of Aviation, it wasn't segregated. They taught whites and blacks. Thousands of black men and women and white men and women learned to fly through the Coffey School of Aviation. But they still were in a segregated environment, so they didn't have as many opportunities. And it was Willa who got the idea, along with Cornelius, that maybe they could get the government to allow more blacks to get pilot's licenses and to maybe even serve in the military as pilots. She became a catalyst for that.
Those who have studied her life say her education and no-nonsense attitude were legendary.
She cracked a pretty strong whip. She was a no-nonsense administrator, no-nonsense instructor. And she would get all up in guys' faces, and they're bigger than she was, to say, hey, you can do this, you know, to give them the spurn it on, to encourage them to get the task done, particularly if they're trying to get a certain maneuver done, if they're trying to do the solo flight, you know, or a certain role or something like that. She would get all up in their face and say, you can do this. So she took a very keen interest in it, so she had to be tough. She had to be tough around men, mainly because of her gender.
A trailblazer in her field, Willa trained hundreds of pilots, many of whom went on to become Tuskegee Airmen.
She was selected by the U.S. Army to provide black trainees for the pilot training program at Tuskegee Institute, who we call the Tuskegee Airmen today.
From the dreams of opening her own business and helping train pilots, the accomplishments just kept piling up for Willa.
She was the first African-American woman to run for Congress. She was the first black woman to hold a commercial pilot's license in the United States. And she remained active even after the Coffey School closed in 1945 in politics and social programs. She was an activist. You know, she wanted to open doors for all people, especially those that were disenfranchised.
She remained involved in public service throughout her life.
During the war, she was the first African-American to be commissioned a first lieutenant. in the Civil Air Patrol. So she was always involved in some aspect of aviation. I believe she also served on an aviation board commission. So she was very much in tune with the field of aviation.
Willa dedicated her life to helping others until the end.
She stayed active in her church even. I mean, she didn't just work with the community on aviation. She was active in all aspects of the community to help people to realize their dreams and to become better. She taught in the Chicago public schools until she retired.
She died in 1992 at the age of 86 in Chicago, but her legacy lives on.
I think what she wanted to show was you can do anything. You can be anything that you set your mind to. You gotta believe in yourself. You gotta not take no for an answer, and you have to persevere. You have to be willing to pay the price. Everything has a price, and I can only imagine the prices Willa had to pay to get where she ended up being and to be able to help other people, because I'm sure there were a lot of attempts to stop that.
Others who have studied her rich life wish they had had a chance to speak with her in person and soak in all of her experiences.
I think I would probably sit there with a cup of coffee, maybe a pot of coffee, and I would put my recorder in front of her, and I'd say, in the beginning, there was a girl named Willa Brown. Tell me about her. And I would just sit back and just let her go. I don't think I could have a specific question because she is such an iconic figure. I would want to try to embrace everything that she had to say. And I would record it for posterity because I would want to play it over and over and over again. I would be awestruck. To me, she's a rock star. She's a rock star.